In this video, we are going to see how to see total website visit count in JavaScript. This is not a static data, this is the data coming from the API. So in this video, we are going to see how to get the value from the API in JavaScript and place the API data inside the HTML content. Fine, you can see if I refresh, the content is getting incremented by one. So let's start the script. I'm going to start the script from scratch. So this is the API link. If you see the API link, and if I click on, each time I refresh, the value is getting incremented by one. So you can see I'm refreshing. So the value is getting incremented by one. And this content is getting, I'm getting it from the API. So I'm going to start from scratch. Let me explain the HTML first. So you can see this is a container which holds one heading and a number. So the container is simply the counter, and the head and the count class I have identified it with the class, not the ID. So let's leave the CSS behind. So let's focus only on the script. Fine, what we need, we just need to initialize the API first. So for that, I'm going to give a link. Before that, you need to create a namespace and a key value on the API. Fine, so copy this link, and you can see there are one value already, which is namespace. Let me give the namespace as, you can give any name. I'm currently giving my channel name, and you have to give key as well, and which is ampersand sign key equal to, you can give any name. I'm giving YouTube channel. Fine, let's start the value from zero. Now if you copy the link and paste it in a URL, if you click enter, you can see your namespace and a key is created only for you. So now you can access this namespace and you can access the key to increment the value by one. So you can see this is not a static data, this is coming from the website. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to get the value. To get the value, you just have to modify the URL link. Get slash, and you have to give the namespace name. At present, I have given the namespace name as, previously I have given create command. Now I'm giving the get command, namespace which is UI monk, and a slash, and the key name which is YouTube channel. And if you, and we will get the value as a zero because we have initialized the value to zero. Fine, if you refresh it, you can see the value is zero right now. So we have seen how to create namespace and key, and we have seen how to get value. Now we are going to increment the value by one. So for that, the same thing, instead of get command, you are going to give update, and in the end, along with the namespace and key value, question mark amount equal to one. I'm saying that you have to increment by one. So if you refresh it, you can see now the value is 1. Again refresh, it's 2, 3 and so on. It is getting incremented by 1. Fine, now I'm going to create a function. It will update the counter. So I have given the name update counter. Using the fetch function, I'm going to pass the URL. It is going to fetch the incremented value, and I will get the result in the then. Let me use the function, nameless function, and we will get the response, and I'm going to convert the response into JSON. That's the way we can read the data. Now again, we can fetch the data in this then function. Pass the function and pass the parameter data, and now you can use the data, and we know we will get in the value. So let me alert it. So if the page is getting refreshed, you will get the alert message. The script I have already included in the bottom of the HTML. Now what I'm going to do is, you will not get the alert because you haven't called the update function exclusively. Now you can see that is total 6, is it? Now it's 7, Now the total, if you refresh it, it is going to get incremented. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to call the counter element with class count. Since there is only one count class, I'm passing the zero. So it will access the div with class count. Now with the help of inner HTML, or you can type inner text, I'm going to pass the value. Fine, now you can see the value has changed. You will get each time a incremented value on refresh because we are fetching the data from the API. That's all for this video. Get the source code in the description. Thank you so much for listening.